Torque is an interaction that affects the rotational motion of an object. To illustrate this with a real-world example, picture yourself at a playground, about to exert force on a merry-go-round. As you push it, the speed of its rotation increases. However, pushing near the center of the merry-go-round requires more effort than pushing near the edge. This difference is due to a phenomenon called torque, which measures the rotational force applied to an object. When you push an object in a straight line, you exert a force on it. Torque is essentially the rotational equivalent of force. Torque is a vector quantity, meaning that it has both magnitude and direction. Mathematically, the magnitude of torque can be represented by this formula. Torque equals r dot f dot sine theta, where r represents the perpendicular distance from the axis of rotation, f is the magnitude of force, and theta represents the angle between f and r. The right-hand rule can determine the direction of torque. If you curl the fingers of your right hand in the direction of the rotation caused by the force f, your thumb will point in the direction of torque. If you know the SI unit of torque, let us know in the comments below. Torque is crucial in rotational dynamics. Similar to how the first law of motion states that an object at rest will remain at rest, or an object in motion will continue in motion unless acted upon by an external force. In rotational motion, an object at rest or in rotational motion will remain in that state unless acted upon by an external torque. Torque is evident in many everyday situations. Let's consider the common example of a door. You may have noticed that door handles are always placed at the edge of a door, far from its hinges, which represent the axis of rotation. This design ensures that greater distance from the axis generates more torque, thus requiring less force to push or pull the door. Trying to open a door near its hinges demands significant force to produce enough torque. Wrenches are another example. Notably, those used by mechanics on large machines often have long arms. The longer arm allows for greater torque, requiring less force to tighten or loosen bolts. Seesaws provide another example. When sitting against a much heavier person, moving to the edge of your seat, farthest from the center of the seesaw, maximizes your torque and makes balancing the seesaw relatively easy. The term torque is commonly used in the context of automobiles and machines, particularly in relation to engine performance. Torque refers to the rotational force that an engine can generate. Engines with high torque values can provide better acceleration, which is advantageous for automobile engines. Torque also plays a crucial role in sports, especially those involving a lot of swinging motion, such as baseball or cricket. In baseball, batters often hold the bat as far away as possible from the expected point of contact with the ball and generate significant force when swinging the bat. These actions maximize the torque at the point of contact, allowing the ball to travel a long distance. Torque is everywhere, from doors and wrenches to cars, and understanding torque is essential for analyzing and designing systems involving rotational motion, from simple levers to complex machinery. Its applications span various fields, highlighting its significance in both practical and theoretical contexts.